how's it going? So this is a quick walkthrough of how to replace the EcoDrive battery of a Citizen titanium interceptor watch. And this is one that I got about 20 years ago in Asia. And it basically, the battery or capacitor battery will at least eventually die. And what you want to do is get this MT621. It goes under two different part numbers. One is 295-5500. Or there's a 295-3300. I ordered the 3300, but they shipped me the 5500, and I think they're the same battery. So anyways, I installed the 5500. There's a picture of it right there. And the first thing I'm going to do is unlatch the strap of the watch so it's actually accessible. Then get this little tool, and there's only one edge that you can actually pop it up from. It's near the 12 o'clock position. Once you popped it off, and it is kind of hard to pop off, but, you know, keep at it, you got to replace or remove this little shield that covers the battery. And it's held in place by a little screw that my little tool is pointing at right now. And once you pop off that screw, then you have to release it in four points all around, which you'll see later on. You're going to go ahead and there's one of them right there that my tweezers are pointing at. And you're just going to get a tiny little screw, pop it off at all four sides. Once that's off, then you want to mount this thing inside this little jig and remove the old battery from the position. And then there it is right there. And here we'll have a video of how to install the new battery once you popped out the old one. Just pop it into place right there. And then you're going to use your finger just to snap it in all the way and make sure the orientation is that little tab is where it is, where it needs to be. Then you put the little silver cover back in place and let it just rest in the right proper place. Snap down each one of these. You're going to hear a little audible snap. Here it is right here. I don't know if you can hear that or not. Do that for all four. Maybe even double check your work after you snapped in the last one. Make sure that each one is securely pressed down all the way. Then you want to go ahead and take that little screw and back it quite a while to get this right. But once it's in place, you've got to really hold steady. And you don't want to over tighten this. You just want to screw it down until it's nice and firm. And once you give it a couple turns and it's got a little bite, then you can tighten it down all the way pretty easily. Now, with that screw tightened in all the way, the next thing you want to do is install the back cover. And right now, the watch is actually working now. But you want to orient this cover such that that little notch lines up with the twisty knob thing on the side. And you'll want to anchor it to the left first and then snap it down where you popped it up from. And you'll hear an audible snap. See that it's actually moving, and you'll see the little double-handed thing, and you're good to go. Charge it up.